This video is brought to you by Brilliant. 2022 was a bad year for politicians. Inflation and stalling economic growth have pushed incumbent government's approval ratings to new lows, and those unfortunate enough to face the electorate have usually been kicked out of office. 2023 doesn't look like it's going to be much better. The IMF's managing director, Kristalina Georgieva, apparently expects 2023 to be tougher than the year we left behind, with a third of the world economy predicted to enter recession. These turbulent conditions should make for some interesting elections. So in this video, we thought we'd take a look at some of the most geopolitically significant elections coming up this year. While over 20 countries are expected to go to the polls this year, including Spain, Estonia, and Argentina, as we see it, the five elections worth keeping an eye on are Turkey, Pakistan, Poland, Myanmar, and Nigeria. Let's start with Turkey. Turkish President Recep Erdogan has now been in power for the best part of two decades. Whilst it might not go down too well with the West, his Islamist-tinged populism is genuinely popular in Turkey, especially in rural areas, and his personal approval ratings have never really fallen below 50%. However, Erdogan's appeal is beginning to wane, both because he's seriously mishandled the Turkish economy and because the Turkish electorate are tiring of his shtick. Contrary to all orthodox economic advice, Erdogan has tried to fight Turkey's surging inflation rate, which, according to unofficial estimates, is running at well over 100%, by cutting interest rates and firing any central banker who resists him. Unsurprisingly, this hasn't worked, and inflation has eaten away at ordinary Turks' purchasing power, causing Erdogan's poll ratings to decline. According to Metropol polling from the end of 2022, Erdogan is now polling behind the four most likely opposition candidates. If Erdogan were to lose the election, which is due sometime before June, the consequences would be pretty massive. Obviously, it would be good news for Turkey's economy, which has been damaged by Erdogan's unorthodox monetary policy. But it would also probably be good news for Turkey's democracy, which has been slowly eroded by Erdogan's authoritarian tendencies. There would also be some significant foreign policy implications. In the last half decade or so, Erdogan has pursued a cynical and hawkish foreign policy that has strained alliances and inflamed regional tensions. Erdogan's replacement is unlikely to follow such an activist foreign policy. The second election worth keeping an eye on is the Pakistan election, due sometime before October. Pakistan's democracy has been under strain since Imran Khan was booted out of office via a no-confidence motion in April. Since his ousting, he's toured the country accusing opposition politicians of conspiring with the CIA to oust him. Khan's rallies have drawn massive crowds, and polling suggests his PTI party, who've performed impressively well at recent by-elections, are on track to win again this year, especially if the current government fail to get a handle on Pakistan's rampant inflation. The third election on our list is Poland. Poland is currently ruled by the Law and Justice Party. Law and Justice have gained a reputation for having regular spats with the EU, usually over so-called rule of law issues. Basically, since returning to power in 2015, Law and Justice have tried to gradually erode the independence of Poland's judiciary, culminating in a 2019 law which basically allowed them to punish any judge who ruled against them. In 2021, the ECJ ruled that this new system was, quote, not compatible with EU law, and demanded that Law and Justice take steps to protect the rule of law in the country. Law and Justice resisted, and for the past 18 months or so, the two sides have been sparring over the issue. This has obviously proved a bit of a headache for the EU, but it's also had some more far-reaching geopolitical consequences. For example, the rule of law dispute with Poland and also Hungary have made many EU members more resistant to bringing in new members, resulting in what's commonly known as enlargement fatigue across the bloc. If Law and Justice lose, the most likely successor would be Civic Coalition, a centrist pro-Europe alliance led by Donald Tusk, who you might remember as president of the European Council during the Brexit years. Polling between Law and Justice and Civic Coalition has narrowed over the past year or so, and a Tusk-led coalition, which would be a big change for both Polish and EU politics, is definitely a possibility. The fourth and penultimate election on this list is Myanmar. Myanmar has been ruled by its military, known as the Tatmadaw, for most of its modern history. They began a slow transition to democracy in the 2010s, but seized power again after a poor showing by the pro-military USDP party at the November 2020 elections, who lost to Aung San Suu Kyi's NLD party. Since then, the country has been beset by violence, leading to the death of at least 5,500 civilians. Nonetheless, the junta have still scheduled elections for later this year, even though Aung San Suu Kyi is currently serving a 33-year jail sentence for a whole load of trumped-up charges, including corruption and violating COVID-19 rules. If the junta keep Aung San Suu Kyi locked up and run a sham election, as looks likely, then it's safe to say that Myanmar will remain a military dictatorship for the foreseeable future. If, on the other hand, the international community can pressure the military junta into releasing Aung San Suu Kyi, as they recently have with other political prisoners, then Myanmar might be able to continue down its bumpy road to democracy. The final election on the list is the Nigerian presidential election, which is due on February the 25th. This election is important both because Nigeria is the most populous country in Africa and due to become the third most populous in the world sometime this century, and because the Nigerian state is looking pretty rickety at the moment. The economy has stalled, with GDP per capita still well below its 2014 peak, and inter-ethnic tensions have flared up again. In the most recent Afrobarometer survey, nearly 89% of Nigerians thought their country was heading in the wrong direction, and 77% were dissatisfied with the way their democracy had been performing. While the recent surge in voter registration suggests that Nigerians are optimistic about the upcoming elections, there have been multiple attacks on the offices of Nigeria's Electoral Commission, and reports that the main two presidential candidates have been trying to buy votes. Perhaps the most interesting candidate in the race is the third-party candidate, who's running on an anti-corruption platform and is particularly popular with younger voters. The election will be a real test of Nigeria's state capacity, and a successful election might go some way to stabilising a country which has been beset by crises recently. So, those are the five elections to keep an eye on. And while incumbents around the world will be planning to stay in office, if world leaders are anything like us, resolutions and plans for the new year are already out the window. If you do want to improve yourself, though, maybe pick up a new resolution and sign up to Brilliant, the STEM learning platform which helps you with exciting new science and maths topics through engaging and interactive experiences. Their courses, including ones co-designed by YouTubers including Kurzgesagt and fellow Nebula creator Real Engineering, bring the topics to life and let you learn by doing, not just sitting in a class like at school. That means that all kinds of topics which previously seemed a little too complex might suddenly be in your grasp. That's things like algebra, geometry, the physics of every day, or even gravitational physics. So up your game in STEM in 2023 to improve your understanding of the world, boost your career, help at school or university, or even just for the sake of lifelong learning. Plus, the first 200 people to sign up using our code get 20% off an annual premium subscription, which is probably a bigger win than most people's 2023 resolutions have been. Anyway, thanks for your support.